Hello viewers, I am Christine and welcome to Retro Movie Review. And this is our show host Paul.
Thanks, Christine.
We are looking back at some movies perhaps you may never heard of, as we focus this week on the early career of the actress Kathleen Quinlan.
This review is for the movie The Last Winter. Kathleen Quinlan and Yonah Elian play two women in Jerusalem in 1973. They are the wives of two men missing in the Yom Kippur War between Israel and Egypt, and when they are watching a movie about prisoners of war, they both think the same man in the movie is their husband.
Can I ask you a question, Paul? This is the fifth movie starring Kathleen Quinlan that we have reviewed.
Yes.
Will you say that she is one of your favorite actresses? And yet, I have not seen anything that I am truly impressed by.
Well, okay. Shortly we will be looking at some of her best work, like her performance in I Never Promised You a Rose Garden.
Well, yes, this was one of her best movie performances, but I do not quite understand what it is that you like about her acting.
Well, I will try to explain this when we look at some additional movie clips.
I think it's going to be a long week. Okay, let's roll the clip.
Beginning being married to a foreigner, an Israeli, was exciting. It's even exotic. Now I'm complete. With a house, a kid, laundry, dishes, and a husband who's fighting in some stupid desert, and I don't even know if he's still alive. Will happen to me if he doesn't come back. I'll begin a new life. I'll do things that I've never done before. I might even fall in love. I got married too young. I didn't have enough time to figure out who I am.
Nobody ever has enough time.
His life stopped at exactly 10:15. Whose is it? Found it in that room in the center. Is that David's watch? It's very much like David's. Hiya.
Have a specific audience. Released in 1984, Kathleen would have been 30 years old.
Thanks. There were a few relationship dynamics in this movie, and perhaps some feelings between the two actresses, or maybe it was just my perception.
Well, Paul, I am sure you're the only person who is giving this film any attention after almost 30 years.
Well, thanks, Christine. I think that perhaps this was the best time in this woman's life, and I am trying to bring the full range of her career to our viewers. And for the viewers that are still staying, the next film we will be looking at is Sunday Lovers from 1980. This film was one of the hardest for me to find. For the viewers that are leaving, thanks for watching.
Yes, thank you again. And see you soon.